Now we have taken these two questions. Now we come to the third question. So when we are looking at science of something, we need to be able to understand our goal. So we take a project and we say, okay, we defined what a project is. We said project needs more science, project management needs more science. One of the scientific approaches is to know your goal and work your way towards a goal. So what are the goals of project management? What are the objectives of a project? What does a project do? So let's take put up an image here to help you. Let's say, so this is an apartment complex. Let's say you're getting either as an engineer or as a customer, you want this, you're going to invest in this, you're going to be part of this. What are your objectives?
Project completion.
Completion, yes.
Within what time?
Okay.
Within the stipulated time.
So time.
Cost.
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 Quality.
Completion.
Safety.
What do you mean by safety?
Should be able to
right. So there's a safety, you don't want it collapsing. So one thing is about the safety of the structure itself
and
the safety of it being constructed. So when it was constructed, you want to make sure that you're not living in a place which took many people, got many people injured or something like that. So from a construction point of view, safety is important. Anything else?
I think completion is also important. Completion.
But all this, we are assuming at completion, you should have met the time deadline, you should have met cost expectations, quality, safety. Yes, environmental considerations. Today that's become very important. Okay. So typically these are the objectives of a project. There might be other objectives. Okay. They, for example, they say good team building. You know, project specific objectives are also there. You know, if it is a social cause, you might say if a project is from a social perspective, you know, social upliftment, there are other things which can come. And the next issue which we want to discuss what do you think is the priority today? So these are objectives.
Cost and time.
Okay, is it cost? Is it, you know, so is this the priority or is this the priority? Right. So there are certainly many projects now. You are saying cost and time. Can we compromise on quality?
No.
So we are assuming this is cost and time given acceptable quality. Given acceptable quality. Okay. You will not accept a very shoddy place immaterial of cost and time. Except we are saying quality should be acceptable. So what you are saying is basically right. There is, it certainly used to be cost first, time earlier on. Okay, especially in the Indian context, if you go back 20-30 years, people didn't put so much importance to time, cost was all encompassing. Okay, now today you know that, I mean, time has become almost in most projects it's become a high priority. You take Chennai Metro, okay, yes, time, I mean, people are looking at the deadline, the whole public is looking when it is going to be opened. There are other projects which were started and gone on for nearly 25 years before it was opened, and it didn't matter those days. But today, you cannot have Chennai Metro go on for 10 years. It has to start open, and so time is a priority. Now, it is such a priority that the owners, the contractors, especially the owners, are willing to pay more to finish on time. Why?
Constructed facility.
Yes. Anything
because
else?
Because it finishes early, the cost and the money we are getting in later profits might.
Exactly.
Be
exactly. So when you look at a project's life cycle, okay, when you finish early and you start generating income from the project, you actually make up whatever money you spent in the construction phase. So if you look ultimately from a corporate standpoint, all businesses are in the business of making money, if you are looking especially from a private perspective, it becomes all this gets related to cost or profit. So I would put cost or profit, all of it, I am even putting environment, safety, everything gets related to this, okay. This is from a business sense point of view. So if for example today time is important, because take the real estate, land value is so high, if I finish a project early and start getting rent out of it, I mean I offset any kind of acceleration cost on my construction very quickly, and that construction phase is only 2 odd years or 3 years max, my income phase is so many more years, okay. So this is the reason today that time has become very important. Let us say quality is something we are taking care. Why is safety not so important today in our context?
Additional cost.
One is people perceive this additional cost, two is
standards.
Yes, there are very good standards in the country, but there is, you know, there is little enforcement, and also people do not pay for poor safety. So a lot of in a lot of the developed countries, people started implementing safety only because if there was a safety violation, it really affected your bottom line, okay. Similarly, environment is very new, okay. We are not even sure what are the policies for the environment. Things are getting only clear now, but again, if you make, say today for example, a green building is a very popular concept. Why? Is that why it's so popular? Is that the only reason why it's popular?
No, it's actually energy efficient, basically.
Okay, one is it's energy efficient,
material efficient,
all of that is there. But it is also that people build green buildings because more people will want to buy a green, invest in a green building. So it really comes down to a business requirement. Okay, so we now move on to the fourth question. So we understood what the objectives of a project are, and we now want to combine actually the second question and the third question and say how do we scientifically manage these objectives, okay. So we went to cost, you know, how do we scientifically manage cost, how do we scientifically manage time, how do we scientifically manage quality, safety, environment. And if you actually go back, you know, even just 2 decades, the answers to this would be each company would have a different practice, okay. It would not be what, there is no standardized method. If you ask me today how do you design a reinforced concrete building, how would you answer me, what would you refer me to?
Codes.
Okay, you will say IS 456 has a reasonable way of, if you follow the practice there, I can get a you know, most kind of buildings, standard buildings I can do. And this has also been the approach to scientifically approach these project objectives, which is the establishment of standards for scientific management, okay. And you have seen, I have actually put, so one of the pioneering standards was the Project Management Body of Knowledge, or PMBOK, okay, released by PMI. Now the ISO standards, which are very popular, the ISO has also now got a standard for project management, okay. It is ISO 21500, Guide to Project Management, very similar to the PMI standard. The Indian standards has also got a guide for project management, 15883, very, and so these standards are quite closely related, okay. And if you actually go into these standards, you will find I've kind of given a broad outline. You will find there are sections on integration, scope, time, cost, quality, human resources, communication, risk, procurement, stakeholders, health, safety, environment, other management issues, okay. All of these, so you can see some of the objectives which we explicitly define, time, cost, quality, okay, are there, quality, and then when you look at health and safety, okay, and environment, all of these are there. These other parts, for example, without human resource development, you cannot achieve these objectives. So the other parts of it are supporting processes which help us achieve these objectives, okay. So this is actually what you call a process standard, which is that if you do things right, the results will be correct. It is not a product standard saying that, oh, this is what I expect out of the product, it is a process standard. Now this is also supported by, you are familiar with the standard, you heard of it, right? What does it do? 9001 to for quality management. Okay, it's a quality management system standard. 14001.
Environmental
standard. Okay, 18001. Occupational health and safety. Okay, so what you find today is there are scientific ways to approach this. There are standards. Okay, if you get into the standards today, and this is a start. Okay, these are only about a few years old, but this is put things into a standardized form, and this is a really, really strong start. Okay, now when we talk about the process approach, the management approach, this is process. So when you get into a process, this is the way you look at it. So almost all of this is similar in its philosophical concept. Basically, this is a very, very popular. A cycle called the Deming cycle or the Schwartz cycle, called Plan, Do, Check, Act. And you will find that most of this course, or almost all of the concepts we cover in this course, has to follow this cycle. So you plan something, you do what you are planning. Will what you do be exactly as per your plan? Almost always no. Okay, then you check, you kind of take action as to what corrections you need to make. Replan, do again. Okay, so this is called a plan, do, check, act, and you will find a simpler version of this is plan, monitor, control. So you plan what you want to do, let us say plan work for the next month, monitor how you are progressing on the work. If you do not if you are not able to keep to the plan, apply control to be able to try to change so that you are adhering to the plan as much as possible. Okay, so another same thing again, plan, execute and control. Okay, closing. Okay, and then okay, say initiating. Okay, actually I should start with initiating, planning, executing and controlling, closing. Okay, so this is a PMI cycle. So if you look at it from another perspective, you are initiating processes, you have planning, executing, okay, and then the monitoring and control is a larger cycle in this whole process, and then you have closing. So what I want you to take away from this is that the whole, so what is the title of this course? Control. So this is the philosophy. We are not putting monitoring in there because it makes the title too long, but you basically need to plan, monitor, control. Okay, and this is the cycle, only if this cycle is well placed, then the whole project will proceed with this is the philosophy with which we take the project forward.